Hello and welcome back to the channel. In this video, I'm going to be showing you guys how to create realistic 3D sections using Autodesk Revit and D5render. So this is going to be very simple and it can be used for presentations and anything you're presenting basically. So it's going to up your presentation game. Okay, so if you haven't done so, make sure you hit the like button, subscribe to our channel for more content like this because we do this on a weekly basis. Also hit the notification bell to join the notification squad so you get notified when we release new videos like this. Without any further ado, let's jump right into the main content of this video. Okay, currently the first thing to do is to of course have the model you want to work on. So the next thing we're going to do is we're quickly going to export it. So if you don't know how to get this D5 icon on your Revit interface, you're going to go to d5render.com and download the D5 Revit Live Sync, which is totally free to get, just like D5. So I'm just going to go over to this tab and I'm going to click export. I don't usually like using the Live Sync, I prefer export. So currently we don't need to check any of these for now, and the export smoothness, we could increase it depending on how detailed we want it to be, but somewhere a bit above the middle is okay. So I'm just going to click on export and I'm just going to save it where I want to save it. So I want to save it in this 02 unit and I'm going to override this and I'm going to click save. So now we've exported from Revit, we're going to open D5. Okay, so one important thing to note is once you've opened D5, it's always good to go over here and make sure that you are logged in. Okay, so as you can see, I'm already logged in into my account. So if you haven't logged in D5, you can sign up to create a D5 render account, which is pretty much free and simple to do. So next, we're just going to go over to this tab here and we're going to bring in our model. So to do that, we're just going to click on it and it's going to open our file explorer so we can locate the model we want to bring. So I'm just going to locate this 02 unit and I'm going to bring it in. All right, so now it's in. I'm just going to click on it. You're going to see it's going to appear under this imported tab and I'm just going to click on it and I'm going to pretty much bring the model in. So once I've dropped the model, I'm going to adjust the movement pattern of D5. To do that, I'm just going to click on this tab here and I'm going to change it from orbit to fly. So I've changed the navigation style. So I'm just going to hold shift and use the scroll keys on my keyboard. I'm going to hold the right click key to turn the direction of my camera and I'm going to hold the scroll button to zoom in and zoom out. So I can just rotate it, zoom in and zoom out how I want. So this is just some little tips on navigation in D5render. If you go to this menu here and we go to preference, you are going to go to widgets. Under this widget, you are now going to see some things. So you are going to see that section tools is currently checked on. You can even check on this advanced camera tools depending on what you want to do. If I check it off, you are going to see the section toolbox tab here will disappear. So it's always important, if you are not seeing it, just go over to this preferences widget, under widget, then check on this your section tools, then close this. So now we have checked on our section tools, we are just going to click on it. So we have two types of sections. We have the section plane and the section cube. So we are just going to be using the section plane here and we are just going to use it. So we can place it vertically or we can place it horizontally depending on how we want to do. So let's start from placing it horizontally first. So we have placed it. Now we can adjust it just like the ways we move other objects by holding any of these movement keys in D5. Then we are just going to drag it up to just cut to the level we want to do. So now we are now going to adjust these views. We can go to this navigation tab here and we can change it to orbit. So we are now going to navigate this. So once we have placed this like this, we are not yet done yet, because as you can see, something is off about this. You can see that even though that is currently daytime, everywhere inside this model is dark. So to change that, we are going to go over to this tab here. Then we are going to check this fill on. After checking this fill, we are going to check this affected by light and affected by weather. What this setting does is that every lighting setting done outside the model is going to be inclusive in this section. So this section will not to no more be restricting the light from entering, as you can see from this model. So now we have done this horizontal section, we can now go to this environment and tweak something. So we are going to change the sun setting, of course. We are going to change the sun position just to get whatever desired thing we want. So let me just change it to somewhere like this. Okay, then I'm also going to adjust this view to someone like this. I'm going to go to this camera tab and change it to 60. So it fits in well. So now, as you can see, another thing to do is we're going to click out there and we're going to click on this section plane. Now, as you can see the icon here. If you click out, let me click on another model. See the icon, I've just clicked on it. So I'm also going to check this fill and I'm also going to check this weather. What this fill does is that, for instance, if I click on this preview field region, you are going to see that it's going to fill it with a color. So I can see currently I set it in black. I can go over here, click on this color, and I can just change it to red depending on what I want. So you can see it's cutting, but I still prefer black regardless. Okay, so now we've done this, we can now go further and apply some materials to the model. Alright, so now we are done with the material application. If you want to know a lot about material applications in D5render, just click on the bloop above. The link to one of my videos I covered a lot about material application in D5render. So as you can see, now the materials are set. What we are going to do is we are just going to adjust it. We can change the navigation tool just to adjust it freely. Then once we have gotten a nice good view, we are just going to go over here and we are going to click on create new scene. So now this scene is created now. We can now click on render this camera icon here to render. We can now edit the quality of this image. Let's change it to maybe 3K. Then we are just going to render it. And once we click on render, we are now going to save the location where we want to render it. I'm just going to call this one axonometric plan. Then I'm just going to click on save. All right, so now the render is ready. We are just going to click on open folder and we're going to see what we've done. So as you can see the render is ready, it's looking clean. So what we're going to do is we're now going to do a section view now. So we're going to close this. We're also going to minimize this. So now we're just going to click on close and we're going to click out of this image. So what we're going to do now is we're just going to select this section plane and we're going to use this green axis here to just rotate it and turn it to a vertical section. So now as you can see, let's cut through this point now and let's just cut it somewhere here. Then we're just going to click on render and we're just going to change this to 3K. Then we're just going to render this and we're going to name this section. Then I'm going to click on save. So now this is done, we're just going to click on open folder and we're going to see what we've done. So we're just going to go over here and just check it out. So as you can see how clean the thing cuts through the whole image and this very informative. All right, so before we move further, we're just going to edit this image on Photoshop. So I'm just going to close this. Then I'm going to click on Photoshop. Then I'm simply going to open my file explorer and I'm just going to drag it into Photoshop. Okay, so now I've dragged it into Photoshop. I'm going to go over to this magic wand tool here. Once I've selected it, I'm just going to select normal magic wand tool. I'm just going to select the background because I want to change the background to white. Then I'm just going to right click and click on layer via cut. So now this is in layer via cut. I'm just going to go over to this layers here and I'm going to drag it down below this layer one. So now I've done that, I'm just going to go over to this FX here and I'm going to change the color. I'm going to add color overlay, then I'm going to change the color to white. You can click on this to make sure it's white and I'm going to click OK. And I'm going to click OK. I'm going to click on file. I'm just going to click on export. I'm going to click on export as. Then I'm going to export this as PNG. So we are going to see the parameters we'll need to adjust to export, but I think they are OK. Then I'm just going to click on export and I'm just going to select go. It's going to give me access to my file explorer and I'm just going to select where I want to export it to. All right, so now I'm just going to click on this. I think this is the one we're working with and I'm going to click on save and I'm going to replace it. So now I think we are done with this. I'm going to click on close. I don't want to save this, so I'm going to close this file. Then I'm going to open our Revit project where the three bedroom, the main project is. So once I've opened it, I'm now going to place it on sheet and I'm going to annotate it illustratively. All right, so now in Revit, the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to go under this sheet. I'm just going to right click and click on new sheet. Then I'm going to be selecting my normal A3 metric blank sheet. Then I'm just going to go over to my file explorer and I'm going to drag this image in. So let's wait for it to load. So as you can see, the image is just white and it just came in seamlessly and it's looking pretty good. Okay, so now I'm just going to drag this image to this point. I think this point is good enough. Then once the thing is sizable and big enough, I could just use the navigation tools on my keyboard to just place it well and adjust it. Now I think this is good, so I'm going to start annotating. So I'm just going to simply click on annotate. I'm going to click on annotate text. Then I'm going to click on edit type to edit the parameters of this text before using it. I'm just going to click on duplicate. So I'm just going to change this font size to 5. Then I'm going to start annotating some components. Like I'm going to name this, let's say this is stone coated steel roofing sheet. Then I'm going to just name, also I'm going to annotate some of these spaces. I'm going to annotate the living area. I'm going to annotate the kitchen. I'm going to annotate the bedroom. Then I'm going to annotate the lawn and I'm going to annotate the car park. All right, so now I've finished these annotations. I'm just going to place them appropriately. So I'm going to be carrying them to the top right corner of the screen. So now I've placed this here, I'm just going to click on this. I'm going to go over to this tab and I'm going to add left side leader and I'm just going to drag it. Okay, let me drag this to this point here and just drag this second point here so it will be looking organized. I could adjust some of these text depending on their location, like this bedroom that is closed here. Okay, whatever, I'll just annotate it like this, and I'm just going to add escape. I'm going to click on this, click on cancel leader, add a straight line, do the same for this, and also do the same for this. Alright, so as you can see how good and illustrative this is looking. You can see the section showing the spaces. I could still go further and annotate the doors. I could annotate the door type. I could annotate the floor finish. I could annotate whatever I want to annotate. So this is just a very good tool for representing your presentations architecturally and very soundly. Alright, so I think this is the end of this video. So this is just to show how to use D5 to get the render of your 3D sections and your 3D axonometric floor plans, and also touch it in Photoshop, carry it back to Revit and render it very well. So if the video was helpful, don't forget to hit the like button, subscribe to this channel for more content like this, don't forget to hit the notification bell to get notified once we release new content, and I'm going to wish you good luck till the next video. Thank you very much.